Started before we went live.
Ready?
Ready? Ready? Quiet. Oh yeah!
I'm drinking the water as fast as I can.
Enough. Oh my God, you're going to slip and slide. Oh, you're slip and slide. All
right.
Oh my God, we got to get this done before we're live.
We're live.
Oh, shit. Oh, God, I'm sorry. All right, so live from Studio One in the Steel Cow Building, located in the heart of historic Wakefield, Rhode Island, the home of Johnny Cakes and Brickley's Ice Cream.
And champagne.
This is the Eden Show, a Greenhouse Entertainment Group production, and I'm Dan Chaika, Master Sommelier and MC for the evening. Eden's guests tonight in studio are the lovely Paula Claire and the indomitable Eliza Collins. And we have so many people online for you people, you're not going to be able to take it. More fun than a barrel of monkeys. Yes, more fun than a barrel of monkeys. My favorite game as a child. So, without any further ado, actually, Eden will be playing Sounds Like a Sondheim Song with Daniel Shigo, one of our previous guests, who also happens to be joining us in our FU Mark Zuckerman program.
Yes!
And is live streaming this on his channel. Since we can't get it on Eden's channel or any of our channels, he banned me after only a minute when I tried earlier during the warm-up. But without any further ado, I talk way too much. Our fearless leader herself, Eden Casteel!
Hi!
Hi! The leader of the loony bin.
Yes.
525,600 minutes. 525,000 viewers sounds fine. 525,600 minutes. That's how long I've been doing this show. It's our Streamaversiry!
Oh my.
I
haven't had a drink since the COVID hit me because it tasted horrible, but yeah. I'm happy to report, folks. I'm back.
Yay!
This tastes wonderful.
He's back and he's bad.
Damn, that's good.
All right, that's good.
All right.
So for those of you who are not drinking, thank you for joining us on YouTube and Twitch and LinkedIn and also through Dan's Facebook, Daniel Shigo's Facebook, because I'm still blocked. It was a week ago. I'm still blocked. I don't know. But thank you, those of you who are joining. So, Daniel Chaika. I tell you, it's been quite a week because I got blocked from Facebook 1 minute into last week's show, and I wrote a parody about it because it really got me down. Do you want to hear my parody?
Always.
Of course you do. All right. It's going to be familiar. I didn't see it coming. It felt like a bad dream. The Eden Show got blocked, and just 1 minute into the stream, I'm stuck in Facebook prison, and I have no clue why. Oh my God, they're harmonizing. Like, that's what I told Facebook when asked to testify. I did. On Sunday night, I talked to somebody in the chat, and he said, oh, I think we'll have it resolved in a couple of days. Last week I asked my viewers, where you watching us? It seemed like a good question, or at least innocuous. But Facebook called it spamming. I'm on their big blacklist. I know. When I watch those other live streams, I get a little pissed. I don't know what happened. It had something to do with me asking, where are you watching it from? Honest to God, I set off some kind of a bot. So I'm not real happy about it, but there's nothing I can do about it. It's just part of the fun of live streaming is that sometimes shit like that happens. I was gonna do this with kazoos. You know, that was gonna be fun.
We don't need no stinking kazoos.
I wa- watch those other streamers telling jokes and playing songs while I hang out on YouTube wondering what the hell went wrong. I didn't have it coming. Facebook set me free. Exactly. I just want to stream my show for you 3, 4, 6 folks to see. Well, if they freed me from this meta jail, if the cyberspace was just, I'd be streaming to 1 million folks and Zuckerbergy dust. Far from Facebook prison, that's where I'll be, I'll know. Until then, I am on YouTube and Twitch and LinkedIn, hosting the Eden Show. Woo! There's my Facebook prison song.
Right here.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
You do that. I'm going to tell our viewers that.
I like that.
This was a better.
Peanut gallery. Peanut gallery. Shh.
This was a better use of your time, Eden. So Eden immediately wanted to sue, and of course, who does she call? She calls me.
My lawyer and personal MC.
And I explained to her, just drink and enjoy, please. And I explained to Eden that it would be a better use of time to write some song and lampoon them, and let's just start the F.U. Mark Zuckerberg movement, which is actually pretty prevalent if you type it into your Google browser. We're not the first.
No.
But as I said to her, we certainly could sue him. Heck, you can sue anybody. I learned that in law school. You're successful is a whole other story.
Right.
And he's got lawyers who have lawyers who have lawyers, which means we would waste all of this wonderful creative energy, and you guys wouldn't have that parody of a Folsom Prison Blues, which is just awesome.
Yeah. Please, yeah, that's just awful. All right, thank you. Hi, David. Hey, Robin. Hey, Christine. Hey, Earl Knightwood. Thank you so much for tuning in, for letting us know where you're watching from. I'm almost ashamed to type anything. I'm terrified to type that something bad is going to happen.
Apparently my mic is cranked up.
Yeah, okay, cranking the mic.
My mic is slipping.
There we go. All right, you can get it really close there. So okay. I have this really pretty mixer over here, Earl Knightwood, so I'm working on stuff over here.
Yeah.
So
Earl, let us know. Is this better?
Hello, everyone.
Hi,
I got a song coming up in this action.
We love you. Yeah, so we need totally.
We need everybody to hear it.
So today is the anniversary day. We started 1 year ago. This is episode 40. 40!
40.
We're middle-aged. And my friends Paula and Eliza are here, and they've been guests before, and they're going to sing tonight. So
I think next week we'll go back to 39, because yeah. It should just be 39.
Exactly. So I put up a little something about what we did a year ago, and I put up a few highlights. It was really fun. I save every episode, and I went through a bunch of them over the week to look at what we did.
You mean Zuckerberg didn't take them from you?
He didn't take that from me.
Ah, thank God for your hard drive.
Yeah. So I'm going to see if I can actually show you the one-year retrospective. So I've put that up in here. Where is it? So we still do
shameless plugs is brought to you by our sponsor,
there we
Eden Casteel Music Studio.
Yeah, speaking of sex, let's sing. Your prostate cancer, I can't help you with that. But I can help you with colons. I can help you with boobs.
It's all access the same way.
It's all access the same way.
My baby don't care for cars and races, unless it's a Tesla.
Ich fahr 99 Luftballons, und dass sowas von sowas kommt.
I'm changing the words cause I lost track because of the conversation.
I was like, what's the best jazz tune to have sex to?
You tell me.
I'll tell you.
Okay, what's the best jazz tune to have sex with?
We can all take a vote. Maybe people in the YouTube room wants to. I say hands down, it is Blue and Green from Miles Davis' Kind of Blue album.
My husband and I were just talking about how our coffee is not caffeinated enough. That's not a metaphor.
I'm a teetotaler myself.
He's gonna order a stronger brew.
I hope you got one of those machines with a timer.
How long does it take to get that drip?
Don't know. Don't drink.
Not anymore.
I only tasted it once. I was six. I spit it out and never touched it again.
There's just so much wrong with this conversation, I can't even begin.
You got a point.
I should point. How do you want me to point? Do you want me to point up or down or side? How do you want me to point?
You just smile and wink. Doesn't matter. I'm ready to go whenever you are.
Okay. We'll smile and wink.
You can sell that one to Maroon 5.
Remember, you almost had it all. That one's for Prince Harry out in California.
That one goes out to Harold Windsor out in California.
Oh, no.
Uh-huh. So oh, if I no. play something like...
Justin. Oh, no.
This is the beginning of a song. You don't have to sing the whole song, but how's
oh, really?
The beginning go? Yeah.
I was there the day my mama told my daddy. I thought you could.
We don't have any milk.
Oh, yeah. So mama went on down to the grocery and she found her new lover, Bill.
There's our song. Woo! On September 2nd, on this date in history, in 1922, the German president declared that Deutschland über alles was the German national anthem. The next year, Hitler complained that everyone was adding too many notes to the melody that just didn't sound like it used to. I had to work in a Hitler joke.
I can understand that.
Right. I mean, I am not Mel Brooks, but if Mel Brooks was here, he would work in a Hitler joke to that. So I felt like I had to write.
And that's like, you know, because of the pandemic, every song has like 50 layers of meaning now.
Well, and you also need a friend to break out the booze with.
Absolutely. Yeah, more of that.
In 1492, Christopher Columbus sighted Cuba and claimed it for Spain under the name Juana.
Said the natives, do you really wanna hurt me?
Yeah.
Okay, please, please don't cancel us.
They're like, what if it was a male singer originally? I'm like, take it down a fourth.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Erica, take it down a fourth, Van Pelt. I like that.
I need that on a t-shirt or a bumper
sticker.
You totally
do. You totally do. Guys, make it happen. Hashtag take it down a fourth. Now see, I'm a voice teacher. I would have ruined you.
That's true.
This hey, is the girl. World. What you doing tonight? I said, hey, Kim. You're such a cutie.
She is.
But this one. This is this one's girl, boo.
No, Dan.
You don't have to let him in. God, no.
Dan, what's no. happening?
You don't have to look at Caddy. Yeah, don't. Here. Really, Dan, I know that you love cats, but.
Oh, no. Get it off. No,
oh, man. Oh, so he's coming to me.
Cats on film.
Cat on film. There he is. This is Jack Black. Meow. Okay, there he is. Pretty much. You speak cat too. Oh my God, you do everything. Every Ohioan knows how to do this.
What is that?
It's the fight song from Ohio State.
Oh, well, I went to Youngstown State.
You might have to give up your Ohio card if you can't remember the fight song from Ohio State. Buckeyes, you can't remember that?
No, I went to Youngstown State because I was a penguin, the Youngstown Penguins.
The Youngstown Penguins, really?
Raise your hand out there if you've heard of them. No, the Youngstown Penguins.
Hands remain down.
You bought all those good old presents. I love you, baby, for the rest of my life.
And then he turned on his necklace.
really good. Do we know any bird songs? Or blackbird singing in the dead of night. Are there any bird drinks, Jim? There must be a bird drink. Is there a bird?
Yeah. Martini.
Now, I don't return things you give me. I wouldn't do that.
I have really good taste.
Because it might hurt your feelings, and it's so impolite.
I had that embroidered for you.
So I just wait several months, and then I burn them. Or I just bring them out to the curb on garbage night.
Honey, have you seen that coat? When the lights go out in Wakefield, weather caused by a hurricane, or a drunk man driving down Tuckertown Road. That's been my week.
Give that man my card. He's going to need a lawyer.
Yes.
Yes. Oh, quick appeal. Anybody within 5 minutes of the house, we already killed the first bottle.
You can bring us another bottle.
You can use another bottle. There's a liquor store right next to the Asian restaurant in Wakefield.
Yeah, that's what you see. We can't have this kind of a party on Facebook. It's for YouTube. All right, so it's been a great year, and that's just a few of the highlights. That was so much fun to go through some of those and see everybody. Oh, my. So 40 episodes, at least 40 guests, 134 viewer song suggestions. Three of them were good. The longest distance guest was Alexander Carot, who was 3,800 miles, and Bernd Kull, who was 3,628 miles.
I got to sing personal Jesus.
You got to sing personal Jesus.
Awesome.
That was really good. Oh, it just so happens, I don't know, maybe I have something from Alexander Carot. Okay, I'm going to play that.
Hey, Eden. Congratulations to the Eden Show's anniversary. I would love to attend this specific Eden Show, however, due to the time shift and my duties as a father, I may not be able to attend, which is why I sent this video now. And I thought I'd do that from a very realistic situation, because I'm really driving my kids back and forth these days because my wife is sick.
She's okay.
And I have so much to do on the side, like further developing SoundJack Lite, which is very well received. Thanks a lot, by the way, for pointing me to this name, which is great. And also we have this Tomana choir going on, like this famous youth choir with 80 participants. And by the way, yesterday it took me the whole day to collect all the equipment and F&Bs to do the onboarding of the singers.
Yep.
So that being said, I really want to thank you for your great contribution in the domain of distributed music. Well, you're more like a saleswoman, as you said yourself, but you really put this topic in scene and really like give it an enormous stage, worldwide stage, which makes people watch videos. Actually, there were people, I had no idea they were in touch with distributed music, and they watched the Eden Show where I was participating, and they really,
yes,
they got the idea, and they were referring to this video, and this is such a great work you're doing. Congratulations to this, and let's keep up the good work and see what future will bring us.
Wasn't that sweet? That was so sweet, wasn't it? Yeah. That's Alexander Carot, the founder of SoundJack, who was our guest and our longest distance guest, yes, right? And we did Personal Jesus. We did 99 Luftballons,
yes,
with him. That was really, really fun.
In German.
Because I asked him and he kind of rolled his eyes, but he did it. And God bless him. I'm so grateful. So, yeah, we had some wonderful, wonderful guests. And the whole reason I do this show, viewers, is because, you know, a year ago, there was this pandemic. Nobody could do any music. We were all at home. I'm so glad things are different now.
It's getting better every day.
Jeez Louise. You know, it's so much better now. But
half the people in this room have already had COVID.
This is true.
The other half are probably going to get it.
This is true. Great. Great.
Not from us.
Just great.
Not from us. We're all negative for a couple weeks now.
Right. 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 I've got fumigation going here. So we had three different, I think the shortest distance guest was probably you, Paula, because you only live a little bit away from me, right?
Or
Eliza.
I win that one.
Okay, well, Eliza wins. So the closest distance, and then even just sitting in this room, I had a few people in the living room. That was really fun. I've had three different live stream companies, six different cameras, three different mixers, four different microphones, two different boom stands, 40 different setups, according to whoever was performing. So every week before you do the show, I would meet with the guest online and make sure that their tech worked and make sure that they felt comfortable with it. And then we would go over whatever songs they were doing. But we did that every single week. And then if the guest was live, then they would come in here, you know, a day or two beforehand sometimes, or at least a couple of hours beforehand, again, just to test all of the tech and make sure it works. We had three total tech fails. Right?
Only three.
Only three. Well,
we rolled with all of them.
We rolled with all of them. We did it.
We got an episode out of each one.
We did.
Even though last week's was in two parts.
Yes. Because of Facebook. Yeah.
F you, Mark Zuckerberg.
Yeah. So, yeah, F you, Mark Zuckerberg. So, if there's anything that you remember over the past year, I'd love to hear about it. You can drop it in the chat if you'd like. But we do have a few guests that are actually online. So, are we ready for our first one?
Yes,
going to be Justin Petersen, who was our very first guest.
Was I really?
You were my very first guest.
No. Are you serious?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, there you go.
So, how you been, Justin?
I've been fine. It's just the same old thing every day.
I'm so grateful that you were the first guest. I mean, because you were willing to do the tech, and you were such fun, and we did country songs because you're like country's number one fan, right?
Oh, well, always and forever. You can take the boy out of Missouri, but you can't take the Missouri out of the boy.
Prove it. You want to sing a song?
Yeah, let's do it. Let's do
one. Sing a Patsy Cline song?
Sure. If you got leaving on your mind, tell me now, get it over. Hurt me now, get it over. If you got leaving on your mind, if there's a new love in your heart, tell me now, get it over. Hurt me now, get it over. If there's a new love in your heart, don't leave me here in a world with dreams that might have been. Hurt me now, get it over. I may learn to love again. If there's a new love in your heart, tell me now, get it over. Hurt me now, get it over. If there's a new love in your heart, hurt me now, get it over. If there's a new love in your heart.
Isn't that great?
That's fun. Hey, happy Streamaversiry to my favorite jailbird.
Thank you, Justin.
I'll make sure to bake you a cake with a nail file in it.
Thank you. Yes, yes. Put a nail file into there and we'll bust out eventually. But thank you so much for being
part of it. We'll be the Velma and Roxy. We'll be Velma and Roxy.
Yes, I love that. He had it coming.
Pop.
Yeah,
squished.
Did he ever?
Uh-oh. So Cicero.
That's right. Lipschitz. Right. We'll do that one for the second Streamaversiry. So glad that you are the very first guest and that you're still singing like an angel.
Well, we're working on it.
You're doing great. You're doing great. Justin is a voice teacher up in Boston way. You're still doing tons and tons of that. You're also a podcaster. I remember you just started that a year ago.
Yeah, we're just noodling. You know, it's two old dudes sitting around talking about singing.
Hey, I've got some old dudes here. We're just talking about singing too. You're in the right place. You're totally in the right place. Thank
There's
you.
There's a future in that. There's a future in that.
We got never know.
Yes, totally. Exactly. Thank you, my friend. Have a wonderful night. Mwah.
Mwah. Happy Streamiversary.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Don't I have great fun? Isn't that fun? He's such a good sport. Oh, he totally is.
So I'm gonna go get more champagne.
Okay, please.
And
hey, Paula, why don't you come up and sing a tune? Come on up and sing a tune.
You're not driving anywhere, are you? You're not driving.
It's 5 minutes away.
No, we can't drive.
Are you serious? You're in the middle of the show to get in your car and drive?
You're just going to get...
What?
No, no, Dan,
no, don't do that.
Not Dan. Now.
I'm taking Jack Black with me. We're going on a roadie.
Are you now?
Come on.
I have something in my whatchamacallit.
Like, oh my gosh. I think that's desertion in the time of peace.
Yeah, yeah.
You guys are good.
All right, move forward a little bit, my friend.
Very good hands.
All right.
I got four guests.
Okay.
Let's see. What, am I here?
Yeah, get a little closer. Come a little closer.
Closer?
All right, can everybody hear okay? Yes, wasn't he great? That's right, Jonathan Christopher. Justin was coming in with the tons. He totally was, absolutely. So this is my friend Paula Claire over here. And Paula, we get to sing sometimes, and you were on twice. You were on for the Leo birthday bash.
Oh, yeah.
And you were on in my living room.
Yeah.
And so apparently, yes, Youngstown Penguins, huh?
We are Ohio girls.
Yeah.
So I really connect with that.
Yeah.
Among other things.
Right.
We connect in a lot of ways.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So we thought, let's bring some happiness into this stream, right? So we should have some happiness into this stream, don't you think?
Because after all, it's very cloudy out right now, and it's winter, and it's January, and we need to feel happy. So we decided to sing this song for y'all to make you happy, because, you know, it'll
it's
make
a happy song.
It's a happy song, right.
Originally done by Judy and Barbara.
Okay, so.
Yeah, good luck.
Forget your troubles.
Happy days.
Get happy.
I hear again.
You better
the skies above. I hear again.
Shout hallelujah.
So let's sing a song.
Come on, get happy.
Of cheer again.
Get ready for
happy days. I hear again. About it now, there's no
the Lord is waiting.
One who can doubt it now.
Shout hallelujah.
So let's sing a song about it now.
The
happy days are here again.
We're heading across the river. Soon your cares will all be gone.
There'll be no more from now on.
Happy days are here again. You better chase
the skies above. Are here again.
Shout hallelujah.
So let's sing a song of cheer again. Happy day.
Happy day.
All right.
Did Dan really go to the?
Yes, he did. I saw his head, his tail lights going up the driveway.
Well, you know, when it's an admission on champagne, this is what you're going to do.
That admission. We're going to be here a while.
Yeah.
Rob, I'm not going to be home for a while, honey, right. So just go to sleep without me.
Right, right. We'll do what we can. So, but you become the MCs, basically. I hope you know that.
Well, we're good.
That's good.
We're good with that.
Thank you, Paula, so much for that beautiful, beautiful song. So what's your memory of the Eden Show in the past year after all the performing you do?
Oh, my gosh. I remember in your living room, mm-hmm. in front of that piano, and I was like, you know, Eden and I have so much in common. I mean, it's like I had so much fun, and I got all dressed up, and they gave me a chance to, you know, wear a new dress, and I was happy.
Mm-hmm. We always like new dresses, right?
But we have a lot.
Yeah.
And
new hair. Eden
is actually my personal shopper, by the way.
I am.
Whenever she's in a secondhand store, she sees something that she thinks that will fit me really well and I'll look good in. She sends me a picture, and then I'm like, buy it, I'll pay you back. And so my wardrobe is expanding because of Eden.
That's because everything I see is like a size 2, and I do not wear a size 2, but you wear a size 2.
Yeah. We just have the same taste in clothes. So
it is good. So, yes, I'm her personal shopper. That's one of the benefits you get from being a guest on the Eden Show is that I become your personal shopper.
She's great.
So that's just a benefit. Hire me. Whatever. Totally. You know, there's somebody else who I've actually bought clothes for and have gotten clothes for, and I'm going to play his thing right now so we can talk about him. Where is he? Oh, yes, Aron Blank. Aron Blank.
Hello, Eden. Hello, all. It's me, Aron. Hello. Aron Blank, that's me.
Oh,
and I just wanted to wish you a happy 1 year anniversary. And you know what I wish for you on this 1 year anniversary? I wish that you don't have to keep streaming and can do things in person more, because God, I did the streaming thing and oh, it's something else. And you do it like real, like you have the technology and stuff. You're really a wonder, honestly. And you're amazing. And you constantly give me your mother-in-law's clothing, which is all I could ask for. I'm not wearing any of it because, honestly, because I wear it a lot and it's dirty and I didn't want to put it on camera. But either way, love to you all. Have a great show. I'll see you soon, hopefully.
Isn't that sweet? Thank you so much, Aron. We love you so much. By the way, tonight you'll notice that usually I have these wonderful graphics where I sit there and I go like this, right? But this is special tonight. This, I would like you, instead of buying me a coffee or a Venmo or anything like that, I would like you to donate to the New England Musicians Relief Fund. That is www.nemrf.org/takes.action. Please donate to the New England Musicians Relief Fund. As you know, right now we're in that wonderful Omicron surge, and so a lot of musical events are being postponed or canceled, and that's really affecting a lot of people that I know personally, some people who've been guests on the show. So when you give to this fund, it helps keep them going until we can safely start performing again. Hopefully that'll be in another month, right?
Hopefully. Fauci says that we're going to be over the hump by the middle of February.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see if he's got that right.
Let's hope so. And so,
I'm hopeful.
We're still booking things, but what happens is we book it and we prepare for it, and then at the last minute, they either get postponed or canceled. So one of the things that you can do by giving to this fund is it helps musicians be able to apply for a little bit of assistance to do things like, you know, heating the house and buying some groceries, paying the light bill. So it's a definitely good fund. I know several different musician friends who actually benefited from this fund specifically. So please give tonight to the New England Musicians Relief Fund, nemrf.org/take.action or take-action. It's really a good fund, and it would make me super happy if you would do that. Oh, thank you, Lisa Marion, so much for that comment. She said, happy anniversary, and she said she wants to come on again. I'm glad to hear that. I'd love to have, as you can see, I have a lot of people on more than once. So Lisa and her daughter Persephone were my guests in the living room, and we had such a good time. Yeah, back when it was safe to do things in living rooms. That was so much fun.
It will be again.
It will be again. And you can see all of the previous episodes of The Eden Show on my YouTube. They're all up there. It's also on my website, edencasteel.com, if you want to see what other performers have done. What's so fun, too, is that all these performers, I know that not a lot of people had a lot of live streaming experience when you started. That's one of the reasons I started this, is because I think live streaming for musicians is going to be a really important part of the future. But it's really helpful to have somebody to kind of show you the way. So I've been happy to do that 40 times with 40 different musicians to help them figure out how to do this kind of streaming and how to be in a small space but still perform to a really high level.
Oh, of course.
Which is awesome.
And what I find really amazing is that you're reaching out to outside of like Rhode Island into other areas and bringing us all together. It's almost like a, it's like a whole community that keeps stretching out across the world. And I think that's a wonderful thing. I mean, it really is. And so what you're doing is a wonderful thing because it's bringing us all together. I mean, I really like seeing people from other countries and other states and other cities. Because then, you know, it's just, we need that right now more than anything.
We absolutely do. That's one thing that the pandemic has taught us, right, is that we're all part of this global village, really, and that nothing happens in a silo, nothing happens on your own. And especially for musicians, we know how much fun it is to be able to play together when it's safe to do it. But musicians, you can also do a whole lot of stuff even when you're not in the same room. The technology is there now to make it happen. And that's one of the reasons that Alexander Carot was my guest, is because he was showing off that technology. And I've been teaching voice teachers all over the world and musicians all over the world how to use this tech. I guess we have more champagne now, thank God. So he really did it.
It's
He really did it.
We're not running out this time.
We're not going to run out this time. This is great. All right, guys.
Oh, I'm back in the seat.
You all get drunk. I'm going to talk to Daniel Shigo now because he is my guest from New York. Hi, Daniel. How are you?
Oh, why have champagne when you can have Cote d'Aron?
That's right. Yes, you having Cote d'Aron? Oh, damn. Of course you are. This is great. Well, cheers to you, my friend.
Cheers to you. I'm in Manhattan, but I wore my Miami Vice vest.
That's wonderful. Shh. I got to keep the peanut gallery down. So, Daniel, you were just here a few weeks ago, and that was so much fun to have you. Remember, we did lots of Sondheim together. It was terrifying but fabulous. That's how I love to be described.
It was.
That's so much fun. It was. And I think the thing that we both loved the most, right, was getting to do the Sounds Like a Song, where we took a suggestion from the audience, and then we turned it into a Sondheim song, right? So with you, I kind of wanted to play Sounds Like a Sondheim, and where we're going to take something from the audience. So viewers, right now, Daniel is here. I'm going to look in the chat and see if there's something.
Can I come up something?
Okay, Dan, what do you want to sing?
Obviously.
What do you want?
Obviously.
Okay.
F you, Mark Zuckerberg.
F you, Mark Zuckerberg. That's what you're going to say. F you, Mark Zuckerberg. Okay.
I wonder why. F you, Mark Zuckerberg. You total schmuckerberg. What were you thinking when you took Eden off the air? Oh, what despair.
That was fabulous.
It happened. Oh, I was going to go on.
More? Okay, go on.
No, it's okay. Go, go to the next one. That was
Here's another one. Okay, from the look of things. This is from, let's see, Jonathan. Is this one of your friends? Yes, I think it probably is. From the look of things, I expect Cole Porter and Bette.
Ooh. From the look of things, I expect Cole Porter and Bette. My God, that's pretty long.
Betty Davis to walk in. Okay, here. It's Betty Davis walked in. That's what we'll do. Betty Davis walked in. Okay.
If Betty Davis walked in, it wouldn't be a sin. Because she'd be up there in her hose with her eyes between her nose. I don't know the rest of this song. If Betty walked in, she's all eyes and with surprise. You can't believe a thing. If Betty walked in.
I don't even think that's a Sondheim song. But what the hell? Who cares? You just
that
made
was
that
sort
up
of
on
like
the spot.
Good. Yeah.
That was good.
Yeah. Bravo. So that's the other thing we do on this show every week is that the guests cannot get out of it. They have to improvise with me to show that it's live and that basically you're hearing my keyboard where you are and then the sound is kind of coming back. So it just shows how the tech operates, right? That's why I do it.
And we're really together. Tonight, we're really together.
Yeah. And that's just...
It's kind of cool.
Thank God, may it last for another half an hour. That's all I need it to last for, and we're fine.
That's why Restream is a much better platform than YouTube or Facebook.
Yeah.
Or Zoom.
Yes. So I'm using, just in case anybody ever wondered how I did this, I'm using Restream.io as my streaming channel. It's going out to YouTube, Twitch, and LinkedIn. It's also going out to Daniel's Facebook page and to Dan Chaika's Facebook page. So that way you can see it from kind of wherever you are. And then when Facebook takes me off of jail, it'll go out to my Facebook page as well. So I love Restream that it can do that. I love that I can talk back and forth and you can hear. It's so much better than Zoom. So if you're a musician that's just been suffering with Zoom for the past 2 years, please talk to me. There are better options, right? Now, Daniel, you're a voice teacher and you're using things besides Zoom right now too, right?
Yes, I use Clean Feed a lot, I have to say. Mm-hmm. So that's a good that one. Works. Yeah.
Yeah. There are some things that help with your video and there's some things that help with your audio. So, and it's fun, I think, to test out all of this stuff because when it works, then you can play with your friends in real time. It's so fun.
It's the future.
It is the future. And I'm not even using actually any of the audio connectors tonight because I'm not. There are so many different other variables and I am the host, the performer, and the producer tonight. But when I have just one guest and I work with the one guest, I'll sometimes add on that audio and it's really fun. And I got to say, even in the past, like, 4 weeks it's gotten better. Each month or two it gets better and better and better. I just think there's a lot of good things to come for that.
There's a new one called Farplay, which I can't use because I have an Intel processor. Can you believe that? In my Mac? It won't use it. I've got to use a desktop or get a new AirBook. It won't do it with my computer, unfortunately. I can't wait to try.
Wendy and I tried Farplay a couple weeks ago. We liked it. And SoundJack also has a lighter version called SoundJack Lite. I named it. Yes. And so it was going to be SoundJack to go, but we started calling it SoundJack Lite, like L-I-T-E, right? And it works great. It's so fast to get on. So whenever you want to try it, let me know. Hit me up. We'll try it out.
Okay. We'll do that.
Daniel, thank you so much for being a guest on The Eden Show and for playing Sounds Like a Sondheim.
My pleasure. Congratulations for a year of joy.
Thank you so much. Cheers to you, my friend. See you soon.
Cheers. Bye.
Bye-bye. Isn't that great? Isn't that so much fun?
Yes. We got plenty.
Oh, thank God we've got plenty. That's what we need. Oh, my God. This is great. Great.
I did promise the guys at the liquor store who gave me a deal on the two bottles. Go to Sweeney's. Sweeney's in downtown Wakefield, the heart of the home of Johnny Cakes and Berkeley's Ice Cream.
Oh, I love it.
Okay. We're going to add those into the list. All right, here's another person saying congratulations.
Hello, Eden. Ed Valley here. Just wanted to wish you a happy one-year anniversary on your Eden show. And it was a pleasure to be a guest on it. I think that was about the best live stream I've ever experienced before. Of course, it was the first and only one I've done so far. But I hope we can get together and do some more of those because I love streaming, and I think at my age, it's very important to have a steady stream. Anyway, good luck, and we'll see you soon.
Here's another.
Did he actually say that?
Hi, Eden. Happy one-year anniversary of The Eden Show. Shannon. Thank you so much for having me on. It was one of the highlights of my past year. So good luck with everything, and let's hope you get out of Facebook jail soon. Bye.
I hope so. And one more.
Yes.
I actually have two more. A lot of people wrote in. I'm so grateful. Karen.
Hey, Eden. I am twinkling for you because you, my friend, are a super amazing and twinkly person. Congratulations on a fantastic year of so much talent. And thank you for having me on there and including me in your incredible show. And I know there is so much in store for you, my friend. There is so much more greatness that we get to see, that you get to share. And again, my sincerest congratulations. And here's to another fabulous year, my friend. I love you and talk to you soon.
Oh my God, those twinkly
Isn't
eyes.
Isn't she so sweet?
Oh my gosh.
Karen was all the way from Las Vegas. She is known as the social butterfly guru. She helps musicians figure out their social media. She's been such a help to me in the past year.
How did you meet Karen?
Karen. I know her from a group of teachers called the Speakeasy Cooperative, and I also know Daniel from that group as well. So the Speakeasy Cooperative is based in California. Our president is Michelle Marquardt DeVoe, but she helps voice teachers and voice professionals work on their business. So she's been very supportive of me, and I've had a lot of different Secovians, I call them Secovians, on the live stream. So Karen and Daniel, Justin's part of that group as well. Rebecca Pia is part of that group as well. Wendy Jones is part of that group. But they're all really dynamic performers and super, super fun. So it's been really great. Yeah.
And go-to guests on the Eden Show.
They're up for anything, which is super fun. They're willing to do anything. Speaking of willing to do anything, all right, Eliza.
Intro.
Yeah, how about that? Okay. All right, I'm checking the mic there. I hope we got a good enough mic.
Now, Paula, so, you've got to move up. All right. Eden, we've changed a verse here.
You changed a verse? Oh, shoot.
This is in honor of the dearly departed Betty White.
That's true. Okay.
Because this song that I'm going to sing that Eden and I put together is called Living Legends, and somehow it didn't seem right to include Betty White and the Living Legends.
Okay, right.
I mean, right?
May she rest in peace.
May she sleep a long and pleasant time.
Absolutely.
So what we've done here,
okay,
Julie Andrews, Meryl Streep.
Okay.
Use books not meant to go to sleep.
Okay.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, Eliza Collins, and she was my guest. She also has done two one-woman shows with me, and this one that you did in November, which was Sex and the Older Girl. And that she's going to be doing it again in March 20th at Arctic Playhouse and Cabaret in Warwick, Rhode Island. So you can come and see it. But for the first time, you're actually going to sing one of those songs right here. Right?
I am.
All right.
For the very first time.
So this was part of the show, but she's going to do it. And Paula was a backup singer for that show.
Paula was. Mm-hmm. And so was Eden.
And so was I. So we're going to do it.
We're going to do it again.
So this song is called Living Legends Don't Need to Get Laid.
What about living legends? Think Jane Fonda can't get a kiss? Think if she wants to get laid, she's forced to reminisce? Think Gloria Steinem goes to bed, cries herself to sleep at night? Thinks because she's all alone, just ain't right. Sticky nights, they've had enough. A goodbye to bedtime charades. Older girls don't want that sweaty stuff.
No sweaty stuff.
The living legends don't need to get laid.
They don't get laid.
To know that men with a full head of hair go for the much younger girls with no curly grays down there. But no living legend I know of would make the necessary trade. Spend some time with an immature man just for a chance to get laid. Oh, sticky nights. Don't cry, living legends. gonna be anyone's wife. Tonight, we've had enough. We've had enough. Goodbye to bedtime charades. Older girls don't want that sweaty stuff.
No sweaty stuff.
Living legends.
Something did.
No men.
Was it good for you too?
Instead of amen.
Instead of yeah, amen, no, it's no amen. Man.
Right. That's good.
Did you get that?
Yeah, we got
did
that.
Did you get it the first time?
Right.
I got it the first time and the second time.
And the second
every time.
And have some more of that secco.
I think I'll have some more of that.
Have some more secco.
Thank you, David.
Well, all so, right, now.
Yes.
What did you like it?
Did you like it? I hope you like it. So.
We wrote that song.
We wrote the whole show. So Eliza's show is going to be at Arctic Playhouse on March 20th, and then other places in Rhode Island later on in spring and summer.
Yeah.
If you want to see it live, come along.
That's right. It's going to be fun. So I'm really, that's one of my favorite songs in your show. I just freaking love that.
I love that song. Packed audience
at the Pump House.
Yeah,
I did.
Yeah, it
I
was.
Packed audience.
But I also loved No Sex at All. No sex at all. So if you want to hear that one, you better come. That's right.
If you want to hear the song, you better come, but don't come.
Great song. Also, all the things that I can't say now, I can say there.
Right.
Okay,
right.
Because I would definitely get set fucked.
Right. Yeah, David said I might have to try off all the way from New Jersey. Yes, this one you're going to want to see. You totally will, because it's just insane. Oh, Heather Statham, thank you so much. Oh. Heather, I love that. Heather is actually doing her own live stream right now. So here's what she wrote to me.
Happy anniversary to you. Cha, cha, cha. Happy anniversary to you. Cha, cha, cha. Happy anniversary to the Eden Show. Cha cha cha. Happy anniversary to you. Cha cha cha. Happy anniversary, Eden. Your 1 year anniversary of the Eden Show. What a treat and a special thing that you have provided, service that you have provided for not only your listeners and your fans and students, but also for people like me who get to be a part of the Eden Show. Thank you so much for having me. Before it was such a thrill, and I had so much fun. I hope that this year anniversary is fantastic. I'm sorry that I won't get to see it live, because I will be doing my own stream because I was inspired by you. So thank you so much for being such an inspiration and a role model. I'm from the South, a role model and one heck of a fine player and singer, performer. I love you much. Happy anniversary.
Isn't that sweet?
That's so sweet.
I know. Yes, Heather started live streaming after she did my show, and she has a band in, I think, is she Georgia or South Carolina? I think she's South Carolina. But her band is Thunder Gypsy. You can find them on YouTube, and they perform regularly now, and they do streaming all the time. That's exactly what I was hoping would happen. Yes!
You are responsible for the gorgeous ladies of streaming.
The gorgeous ladies of streaming. What is that? Gloss?
Gloss.
That's
gloss.
Yeah, gloss. Gloss. That's gloss.
Wendy
gloss.
Jones.
Heather That's Tudum. Right. I do know.
We've had some wonderful, wonderful guests.
I do know some good-looking people. This is very true. I'm
well,
very lucky.
Not so much how they look. It's that they're able to perform spontaneously and come up with stuff in songs like a song.
This is true. This is true. So, Dan, we already did. I mean, when we first started the show, I was having you do like the little legal minute. You already told me I can't sue Facebook. So I feel like
I've gotten my legal advice. But your energy is better spent lampooning Facebook, which is what we're doing all our
This is good.
That's right.
This is good. This is good. Fuck Facebook. I think we've established that pretty thoroughly. Absolutely. So Dan, you're also a singer, a fine singer, and we have done songs together over the course this year. So now I want to hear you sing a croon of few.
I'll croon for you.
All right. I'll give you the full intro, okay? Because I love how you sing the song. And you're dressed for it.
I can only give you love that lasts forever, and a promise to be near each time you call. And the only love I know for you and you alone, that's all. That's all.
I'm glad I don't have to play it.
I can only give you country walks in springtime, and a hand to hold when leaves begin to fall, and a love whose burning light can warm a winter's night. That's all. That's all.
There are those. A toy, right? All I have are these arms to enfold you,
and a love time could never destroy. If you're wondering what I'm asking in return, dear, you'll be glad to know that my demands are small. Say it's me that you'll adore, for now and nevermore, that's all. That's all.
Yay!
So the takeaway from that is,
yeah,
don't look up the lyrics at the last moment on YouTube because it's a different song.
Yeah.
Everybody's done that. We was did it, the Nat King Cole version.
Was it Genesis?
I got the Genesis.
Yeah. Of course.
Of course.
Of course. Yeah.
And I'm looking at it going, where's my line? Oh, live television.
Oh, live. Yeah, live streaming. That's the fun you have on live streaming is you just have to make shit up. That's what we do, right? Totally. Well,
where else can you run and do a packy run in the middle of the show? Come on.
Exactly. That was
Remember,
really fun.
Sweeney's Liquor Store in downtown Wakefield, Rhode Island.
Thank you, Sweeney's.
Where the guy gave me two bottles of Prosecco for almost the price of one.
Aww.
Like on the show.
Thank you so much. Sweeney's,
so
we love you.
Stock up. Tell them you saw it on the Eden Show.
So we're going to take out like Brickley's ice cream and just put Sweeney's in, right? Sweeney's in the intro? Okay, we totally are. We totally are. Okay, boys and girls, it is time for Shameless Plugs, Shameless Plugs. If it was me, I would go out and see it. Shameless Plugs.
Hey.
All right. Shall I read my own intro?
I don't know. I can read it. You got to hand it to me.
Go ahead. Right. You do that one. Yeah.
The Eden Show is brought to you by Eden Casteel Music Studio. Thanks, beautiful sponsor. Work with Eden to upgrade your singing, write and record great songs, and become a musical badass. You might win a Grammy, you might perform at an open mic, or you might wind up as a guest on The Eden Show. And as we all know, 2 out of 3 ain't bad. Learn more at EdenCasteel.com.
There's shameless plug number one. Next shameless plug, our friend Karen Besson is directing a comedy at Barker Playhouse in Providence. Ripcord is an expertly engineered situation comedy about adversarial roommates in a retirement home. Opens January 28th. Tickets at playersri.org.
I'm going to the matinee on Sunday. Gotta
That's
be proud.
Absolutely. That's going to be super fun. Next shameless plug.
Ooh, this is a good one.
I am playing for Poppy Champlin's comedy class graduation at Pump House Music Works on Friday, February 11th. And together we are hosting an online comedy music workshop. So if you want to know how to make your songs funnier, if this past hour has said meant anything to you, then you're going to want to come to our online comedy class, Make 'em Laugh, which is going to be on Tuesday, February 15th, online 7 to 9, more like 7 to 9:30. You can sign up at edencasteel.com. That's going to be how to make your funny songs funnier.
A bargain. Mm-hmm. About the same price as dinner for two at a mid-level restaurant with a couple of drinks. Just bring your own. We'll entertain you. There'll be hors d'oeuvres on the table.
Right. That's right. We can promise you maybe some Sweeney's.
Get that liquor from Sweeney's Liquor Store in downtown Wakefield, Rhode Island.
Exactly.
There's the shameless plug. That's another one. All right. And then Sex and the Older Girl. Eliza Collins's hilarious one-woman show is coming to Arctic Playhouse in West Warwick on Sunday, March 20th. Tickets are available soon. You're going to have a tour. It's going to be an actual tour.
And I can't wait to go to that one. I was in D.C. for the last show. I really was sad that I missed it.
This is going to be, it's totally worth seeing. So I think we're going to have an opener before it, or we're going to have an open mic afterwards, or probably both. Full bar, great place to be. It's like
easy parking,
table seating. Get a group of friends and come and see
open
Sex
mic,
and the Older Girl.
I get to sing too?
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Right. It's fun. You got to come and do it. And last but not least, I am performing a tribute to Madeline Kahn called Kahn Artist, which will be on Tuesday, July 26th at the same place, Arctic Playhouse in West Warwick. Tickets are on sale now at thearcticplayhouse.com. Be sure to check out their hilarious main stage shows and the whole year of cabaret performers in their cabaret club.
And I am really looking forward to that.
That's going to be really
cool. Hopefully you won't be so damn tired.
I know. Oh my God. Here I am, the goddess of desire. Set men on fire. I have this power. I've been working on it. So it's going to be really, really fun. So that is the end of Shameless Plugs. Shameless Plugs. Bunk, bunk, bunk. That's the end of Shameless
Everybody
Plugs.
Everybody has their favorite Blazing Saddles line, don't they?
It's true.
Didn't you do Young Frankenstein?
Yes, she did.
Of course she did. Oh my God.
I don't even have to sing one note in this cabaret. All I have to do is like let the audience do whatever the hell they want and just stand there. This is great. I don't have to do a thing. This is wonderful. I have one more fun little thing. Hallie Elwell could not be on to do a video, but she wanted me to let you know that she really appreciated being a guest on the show. Hallie's a wonderful singer-songwriter based in Maine, and she's got a new album out. She premiered some of her album stuff when she appeared on The Eden Show last year. So she says, I wish you all the best. Thank you so much for creating a fun and entertaining show. She was honored to be a guest. Hallie, we were honored to have you.
Yes, we're bringing her back. She was a goodie.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She was good. I liked her songs.
Absolutely. Yeah. She's a really great songwriter and singer and teacher. And I also know her from the Speakeasy Cooperative. So if you're a voice person watching this, we should probably talk about the Speakeasy Cooperative. But now I think we are near the end of our time. And it's 8:01. So I have, already.
That went fast.
Keep drinking.
Yeah, give me your glass.
Yeah. All right.
There's an empty glass sitting at the end of your...
I was really inspired. I was watching like a James Bond movie the other day, and I decided I would do one more song that's just kind of how I'm feeling. So go figure. Nobody does it better. Makes me feel sad for the rest. Nobody does it half as good as me. Baby, I'm the best. You weren't looking, but somehow you found me. Until I got kicked off of Facebook. But like heaven above me, viewers who love me, celebrating with us online tonight. And nobody does it better. Though sometimes I wish someone would. I'd like to clone myself sometimes. Nobody does it quite the way I do. Why'd I have to be so good? The way that I live stream whenever I live stream. There's some kind of magic inside stream. Gonna keep this show running, and I'll keep it coming, and maybe I'll show you how to do the things I do. You could pay me, 'cause nobody does it better. Though sometimes I do need a rest. Nobody does it half as good as me. Good grief, will somebody else please do this so I don't have to do it every frickin' week? Baby, I'm the best. Keep drinking. Baby, I'm the best. Viewers, you're the best. Thank you so much for being part of the Eden Show. Thank you, guests, for this past year. We really, really love you. We really, really appreciate it. We will see you next week for Mary Catherine Ward is my special guest next week. I'm so looking forward to that. Cabaret singer who's supposed to be here in November. She is coming back. So we will see you for that. Then after Mary Catherine, we've got Natalie Blue on February 10th. We've got Mark Cutler on February 17th. So looking forward to all of those people. Thank you so much for a wonderful first year. Mwah! Thank you, Dan, my personal lawyer, emcee. Thank you, Eliza, Sex and the Older Girl. Thank you, Paula Claire, my Leo in Ohio and Buddy. Thank you all so much for watching, and we will see you next time. Mwah! Good night.
Good night.